We need to take our stand. We have victory in Jesus. You and I, the Word tells us, you are an overcomer by the blood of the Lamb and the Word of God that's in your testimony. Yes. Hallelujah. You're an overcomer. Hallelujah. You don't have to give in to the lies of the enemy. You can walk in absolute victory.
Amen.
God Himself said that He was the God. He was the God that would give you victory.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
That He will lead you. He will teach you. He will help you to grow up to become strong in the Lord and in the power of whose might?
His might.
His.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
This is why if you're walking in the power of His might, you don't keep falling into sin. So many people say, well, I'm trapped. No, you're not. For those whom the Lord hath made free are free indeed. You're not trapped. Oh, but Satan's been lying to me. Yeah, but who's been listening? Come on. Who's been listening? Well, see, this is what Naaman was going through. Naaman came from a land where there were many, many, many gods, but not one of them could heal him. Not one. Don't you know that he went and took offerings and all kinds of things to those gods? I mean, when we were in Japan, we saw faceless gods. And yet there would be literally thousands of dollars laid in the offering area at the feet of those gods. So I asked one day, I asked him, I said, well, who are these gods? They have no hands. They have no face. Who are they? Oh, they said, oh, these are the gods we don't know. You think a God I don't know is going to get my money? Only the God I know is going to get my money, because I know He'll bless me and take care of me.
Amen.
Amen?
Amen?
See, I know my God answers prayer, because all of my life I have seen miracles. I watched one time at our church in Chowchilla when I was the youth pastor. I watched a goiter. I mean, it was huge on the neck of our pastor's wife. And I stood there as we prayed, but I watched with my eyes as the goiter dissolved and her little skinny neck went back to normal. I've seen cancers removed. I've seen women that were going in to have both breasts removed, have muscle tissue removed, and God completely healed them. They didn't have to have surgery. God take someone's blood that is messed up and fix it and make him whole. He's sitting right there, Brother Tom. I got to sit over when the hospital was over there on 13th Street. I got to sit in on a thing where I watched on the TV as the camera went into the arteries of one of the men of our church. And you literally, I start talking in tongues. I think I scared the nurses and doctors out of their minds. But I start talking in tongues. You could see the plaque dissolving as the camera moved forward. It just dissolved. And when the doctor took the camera out, he said, there's nothing to remove. It dissolved. It's gone. This is the God we serve. Amen. Amen. Come on. Yeah. He is a God that can heal. He is a God that can deliver. He is a God that will give you the desire of your heart.
Hallelujah.
If you'll seek after Him.
Yes.
Amen. Amen. You put God first. And all these other things will be added unto you. You want healing? Put God first.
Amen.
You need deliverance? Put God first.
Woo.
Let God be first in your life and you'll see God move in your life. You'll see a transformation. You're going to see your family members saved. You're going to see God begin to do things for you that you've never seen God do. Because that is the God we serve.
Amen.
Amen?
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.